by Global Star uses second-generation satellite technology that allows customers to track themselves and their assets, send messages, and contact search and rescue. Spot Trace is the theft alarm tracker that monitors the movement and location. Spot Gen 3 lets off-the-grid adventurers send messages, track movement, and call for help. Spot by Global Star, satellite technology. Support for WYES is made possible by Mary Lou Kristovich in memory of her husband, William Kristovich.
Scott Laborde, and welcome to Steppin' Out, spotlighting the New Orleans area's arts and entertainment scene. Seated at our table tonight, Poppy Tucker, host of the WWNO radio program, Louisiana Eats. Hello, dear.
Hi, Peg.
Hello. New Orleans traditional jazz musician and band leader. We're talking piano and banjo and much more, Lars Edegran. He is also the leader of the New Orleans Ragtime Orchestra, and Lars will be performing for us tonight a little bit later with Topsy Chapman and Louis. Welcome, Mr. Lars. Hello.
Thank you.
On the piano that you donated to us,
right.
So that's good news. And Steppin' Out's theater critic, Alan Smason, editor of the Crescent City Jewish News. But first up, some accolades for somebody very special.
And what a party, what a lot of fun we had last night.
It was fun.
Yes, Ralph Brennan got a very well-deserved deserved distinction last night. He received the Ella Brennan Lifetime Achievement Award, which is given out by the New Orleans Food and Wine Experience. And that was not nepotism. Ralph absolutely deserved it.
Definitely.
It was a fabulous party. Mm-hmm. All the Brennans were there. It was the best. I don't know when I've had such a good time.
We should point out that bottle is very unique. That is the award that they give every year. And Mian Fage designed that. So I just think that's kind of cool.
It's a pretty fabulous thing to have.
Yeah.
Well deserving that award. And we're going to talk about Ralph's on the Park right away, because I didn't know that he does an Oktoberfest there. Mm. There's Oktoberfest, amazing places. Through October the 29th, you can get three courses for $37. And the choices are divine. House-made soft pretzel with camembert cheese, or spätzle, Creole mustard dumplings with jumbo lump crab, green peas, and brown butter. That was one of the most delicious things I've ever had. There's German lager and cheese soup. They have stuffed veal cabbage rolls in a veal reduction. Oh, that was so delicious. Mm-hmm. Sauerbraten, schnitzel Holstein, and the desserts. Warm apple strudel with vanilla sauce and Creole cream cheese ice cream. And how about gingerbread and candied bacon trifle.
Just a quick personal note, Errol and I did that just like on the spur of the moment last week. We so enjoyed it.
It was delicious.
It's a very good value, too.
Oh, yeah, that's what a deal, $37. Mm-hmm. Now, our dear friend Guillermo Peters over at the Canal Street Bistro, he's doing an incredible Oktoberfest menu through October the 29th. He has one of the broadest menu choices for this of anybody I've seen yet. Leek and potato soup, sweet dill cucumber salad. He has cheese baked spätzle, which I haven't had yet, but I know it's gonna be good. Grilled brats and blotwurst, Jägerschnitzel in a cognac mushroom cream sauce. You can have crisp roast duck, braised pork knuckle, sauerbraten, dessert, black forest cake, pear torte, and Leipzig carrot cake. Yum, yum. Now, moving on to Middendorf's. They do an Oktoberfest, and that is on Wednesdays and Thursdays for lunch and dinner, and that runs through November 11th. Next week it's Sauerbraten, then it's Wiener Schnitzel, it's all of the German dishes you love, and nobody cooks it better than he. And of course, still going on, Oktoberfest at Rivertown in Kenner. And that is going on every weekend through the 22nd.
The good old Deutsches Haus.
And I just have to say one other thing about our buddy, Ralph Brennan. I didn't realize that they would do this for you. If you call Ralph's on the Park and you make a reservation and say it's a special birthday or it's an anniversary, they print a special menu. See, it says Happy Birthday, Philip. Mm. That was really a fun dinner we had. So isn't that the coolest thing?
Yes, yes.
Wonderful touch.
Absolutely. And just back to Middendorf, just to remind everybody, of course, that that's where Horst Pfeiffer is these days.
Oh, of course, thanks.
It's the German connection.
Of course, of course.
But and that's where they are. No other presence in New Orleans, per se, are
no.
they?
No, and of course they had Bella Luna.
Yeah,
and sometimes you can buy fresh pasta from him that he's making there, too.
So he and Karen, that's their thing now.
There's a million reasons to stop at Middendorf's.
And they've also expanded the place, so it's, yeah, anyway, good for them. Thank you so much, yes. And New Orleans Magazine's quiz queen, Julia Street, has a question for us. Last time, Marie and Kona named three of Antoine's famous rooms in the back on the first floor. You could have answered the Rex room, the Proteus room, and you've got also the Escargot room, the 1840 room, or the Tabasco room.
Oh, so known as the last room.
Yes, yeah, the last room, that's right. And now tonight, and that's where New Orleans Magazine was created, by the way. It was founded by businessmen 50 years ago. We'll talk more about that later. Anyway, our question, traveling east to the Florida Panhandle, God bless everybody there, of course, at what city, as you're on your way, is there a tunnel? And then, what is the first city in Florida? Email your answers to steppinout at wyes.org. Our prizes. Tonight we have a t-shirt with a message, soon happens, okay, from our friends at wearablevegetables.com. We also have a copy of the Pelican Publishing titles, Arnaud's Restaurant, and that's a cookbook by Kit Wall. Plus, we have Broussard's Restaurant and Beautiful Courtyard and all that by Anne Benoit and, of course, the Preuss family, who are the former owners. Plus, we have a $50 gift certificate to Kitchen Witch Cookbooks on North Broad Street, and they're still doing their Friday night Sip and Shop event, and this week they've got a grilled vegan food pop-up with food available for purchase, and they also have some free libations, too. So that's Kitchen Witch. They offer all kinds of great things. You can visit WYES.org for our online calendar to see our lineup of events, including the Fall Garden Show Festival at City Park tomorrow and Sunday, Gina Ware Sale tomorrow in Bienville in Mid-City, and the Mid-City Pirate Pub Crawl tomorrow evening, starting at Trejo's on Tulane. You can also link to our WYES YouTube channel to our program. And now, though, we are so delighted to have Mr. Lars Edegran with us. And Lars, as we said, you wear many hats, but first up, you are in charge, the wonderful George Buck, who came to New Orleans now, I guess, over, 20, 25 years ago for the love of the music. I know that he and his wife, Nina, loved jazz, and he had loved it since a child. But he also bought some of the small labels through the years, and thank goodness, took those records and transferred them to CDs, and you were in charge of that these days. The late George Buck, we miss him.
Right. George, he started in the record business back in 1949, so he's actually the oldest independent label in America now. And he was, of course, his main business was radio.
He owned
a whole bunch of radio stations.
Wow.
And the jazz music was really his hobby, but he made it into a huge hobby, because now we have about 1,400 CDs in circulation. Mm-hmm. So we're very large for an independent label.
Well, I know you all started with sort of the re-release, as we said, transfer, to CDs, but you continue to produce new CDs, and we're going to show some of the CD covers, too,
Yeah, we do new recordings, not as many as we used to, because we have to limit how much money we spend, because George is not here anymore. And George, he used to fund his hobby.
Right.
But now we have to stand on our own legs, so to say.
Yes.
So we don't spend as much money. Plus, CD business is not as lucrative as it used to be.
So it was sort of a labor of love for him, but hopefully he'll try to recover his cause, too. And of course, and look, Danny Barker, oh my goodness. Now, and we should point out that this is located right behind the Palm Court.
Right.
That you can actually go and buy the records, or CDs, rather, or you can order online, and we'll show that information as well. But the Palm Court is a wonderful place to hear live music and jazz almost every night, and dine, too, huh?
Right. It's a good place. You can dine there. You can bring kids. Which is not that many jazz places you can do. Preservation Hall is one that you can.
Right, and you all have your own band, and what's so neat is that the band performs not only at of course, the Palm Court, but there's this annual Nicola Dance series at the Maison, and so part of the Palm Court band, I understand, is going to be playing there soon?
It's basically the Wednesday night band.
The Wednesday night band, usually that's a Palm Court.
Because we have different bands on different nights.
Right.
And this is the Wednesday night band. And this is the band that we've been touring in Europe with also.
So you had a busy summer.
Yeah. We did a nice tour in Europe. This is the fourth tour that we've done in Europe with the Palm Court Jazz All-Stars. We started way back the year before Katrina. And also the year of Katrina. We all got stuck in Europe.
Oh, jeez. And if you got to get stuck somewhere.
Right. It was okay.
Yeah.
So it was a lot of us in the band and two vocalists, so it was very complicated.
Okay. We should point out, Lars, that you, even though I know you're a long-time Orleanian, there is a bit of an accent. So where are you from originally?
I'm originally from Stockholm, Sweden.
Yes. Yeah. And you and other musicians came from, like, Sammy Rymington from England. You know, you came here for the music.
Right. I came
here. Orange Callan.
Originally, I came to Chicago, actually.
Okay.
Because I had a job in Chicago working for another record company called Denmark Records, is still around.
Well, we are so glad you're here and that you're going to be performing for us. And now, though, we look forward to having Lars and singer Topsy Chapman and saxophonist Lewis Ford. They're going to be performing I Can't Believe That You're in Love with Me. Like I'm the lucky one.
to me.
Wonderful. Once again, the Palm Court All-Stars will perform with Topsy Chapman at the Nicola Dance Series that's at the Maison. That's Sunday week. That's Sunday, October 16th from 4 to 7 p.m. And it's free. What a deal, of course. And I'm sure there's a bar available and all that, but that's a really great opportunity. Now it's time, though, for our Artist Spotlight. Tonight we are featuring Lemon Lovers 2, Digital Collage 2 by Alana Luger-Guillaume and Rebecca Spackenthal. Both artists are included in the exhibit Lemon Lovers, which opens tomorrow night with the group exhibit Inscribe at the Front Gallery on St. Claude Avenue. There's a performance by Spackenthal at 9 p.m. And there will be openings all along the St. Claude Avenue District's corridor from 6 to 9 for the second Saturday Art Walk. And, you know, as we, of course, you know, mentioned last week, New Orleans lost one of its broadcasting pioneers recently with the death of Terry Flettrich Rowe. Whether you knew her as Miss Muffin or the host of the Midday Show, you knew that she was a star. And tonight we pay tribute to her in her own words with memories of her career from an interview she did with producer Dominic Massa for the WYES documentary New Orleans TV, The Golden Age.
I started working at D.H. Holmes in the early 40s, I guess when I first came here. And I was doing everything for their communications. Yeah, I was doing radio and some little essays and, you know, the gamut. I'd never seen television. I hardly knew what the word meant. And I said, well, I've never seen television. He said, oh, nothing to it. I said, well, can't I at least take some time off and go to wherever they have it? I don't think they had it south of the Mason-Dixon line. And he said, no, there isn't time. There isn't time. You just put these programs together. Because don't you know, he said, television is just radio with pictures. And I've never forgotten those magic words. Sometimes that's all it is. So I was doing the writing and producing, and it was, an hour program. And Vera Massey was a very beautiful woman. And they hired her. Then she left, and she left rather precipitously, so they hadn't found a replacement. And so they asked me, Louis Reed, whether I would take over. And again, you know, never done it. And he said, it's just for a little while. We'll get somebody else. We'll get someone from New York. Would you do it just for a little while? So I did. And interestingly enough, there was a rating period, and it went sky high. And so I got stuck in it. And I got to enjoy it.
It's high noon in the Crescent City, and time to catch up on the news with a lot of people on Midday, 60 minutes of information and fun. Produced for you on Midday by Terry Flettrich.
Hi, and may I wish you a perfectly beautiful day, another in a long string of lovely days.
And there were many of us. It was Al Shea doing the theater, and then the Cars came in a little bit later, but they were doing family stuff and decorating. And Wayne Mack was the announcer on the show, but he was so much more than that. It was a family. As a matter of fact, we called ourselves the Midday Family. I loved kids, and somehow kids came to me, and I tried to instill kind of churchy things, you know, caring for your fellow man. Well, I think probably that was the most exciting thing about it. Yes, because we didn't see it, we didn't know what it was, we didn't know what we had to produce, so we really had to crawl into whatever ingenuity, intuitiveness, imagination, whatever. And so we did our damnedest. And, you know, I guess it wasn't too bad. Because as I think about what we did, it was, some of it is about as good as it gets.
Wow. Terry was 99 years old. She is survived by her two daughters, Patty and Loanne, as well as three grandchildren and six great-grandchildren. Wow. And our very best to Bob and Jan, who are still with us and keeping busy. And now to Alan.
So we're going to talk a little bit about Judy Kuhn. I mean, it's not often that we have, what, a big four-time Tony nominee coming into New Orleans to enjoy our atmosphere, as it were, but also to kind of regale us with performances. And so she actually was on stage at NOCA. This is part of the Mark Cartalli Broadway at NOCA series. And she was magnificent in voice.
It was last night.
Wow. And Seth Rudetsky was, of course, playing the piano and doing the interviewing. So it's a great series. Mark Cartalli, of course, seen with her here, is the producer of the series, and he's going to be bringing back in other Broadway show names that you'll see. Gavin Creel from She Loves Me recently in December, and Anna Pascal, who was in Rent, of course, in January. So we're looking forward to that. Now, meanwhile, tonight, the wraps come off, literally, on Pictures of Maryland, the world premiere musical and multimedia presentation that's being put on by the National World War II Museum at BB Stage Door Canteen. Here we see Courtney Anderson Bowe. She is, you know, the picture of Marilyn Monroe, who, of course, was also Norma Jean Baker in real life, who started working in the wartime factories of World War II, and that's the connection to the National World War II Museum. This is an original work that was written by Kevin Hallman, who we recall is the actor who played Tom in The Glass Menagerie last year. By way of transparency, I tell you, I saw two of the readings that were done beforehand, and I've watched this work transform from a very long to a very refined piece. It is really worth seeing. Victoria Reed should be complimented, of course, as the entertainment director there. Really, though, from the first time I ever laid eyes on Courtney, I said, oh my goodness, this is somebody who deserves to do Marilyn Monroe. And so again, she's going to be ending her run as a Victory Bell there with this performance, so she's going to be sort of moving on, but we hope that everybody will take advantage of this. I understand it is sold out this weekend, so check it out through November the 28th. Meanwhile, over at the University of New Orleans, the quirky cast of New Orleans characters found within Airline Highway will be seen. That's for the mind of playwright Lisa D'Amore. And this cast, it includes Lance Nichols and Lisa's own brother Todd D'Amore. Of course, this show really was on Broadway just last year. We'll recall Todd was in Orpheus Descending as well. The official opening night is Monday night, but there are previews that are still on. But I believe, again, much of it is sold out. So I suggest you search for any seats that are left quickly. A regional premiere will have a number of New Orleans references that have been written back into the play that were taken out because they would have been lost in New Orleans, New York audiences instead of New Orleans audiences. So this is Airline Highway is going to be playing through October the 23rd. And speaking of Southern Rep, they have announced that their new home, as it were, for the next 2 years will be at Loyola University. They've actually moved their offices into the Loyola University Uptown campus. Next month, they'll be kicking off their season with a regional premiere of Grounded, which is starring Carrie Cahill. It's a one-woman show about an Air Force officer who is forced down to Earth to pilot drones after she becomes pregnant. She joins the chair force, if you understand that, okay? Again, Grounded is the first, and then for the Tennessee Williams New Orleans Literary Festival, they're going to be offering Sweet Murder Youth, starring Leslie Caste, directed by Tulane University's faculty member Mel Cook, who I saw last year after doing a wonderful all-female performance of Julius Caesar. So again, if you get a chance to see that. And last but not least, Civil War drama that's going to be doing is Father Comes Home from the Wars, Parts 1, 2, and 3. That'll be in the spring. But a wonderful opportunity to see those for Southern Rep. Laura Hope, who of course is the head of the faculty at the theater department at Loyola, is really excited. She's gotten now the backing of her administration, and she's advancing her program. She says that she's never had as large a class of incoming people as they have at Loyola now. Their season kicks off with Beyond the Horizon, which is Eugene O'Neill's very first play, of which he won four Pulitzer Prizes. Beyond the Horizon, October 14th through the 22nd. And then the second play will be The House That Will Not Stand. That's an adaptation set in New Orleans of The House of Bernardo Alba, which was, of course, written by Federico Garcia Lorca and was set in the Civil War in Spain. But this has been made into the 19th century in New Orleans. Finally, a musical that will round out the year in the spring is The Spitfire Grill. Now, one other show coming up is going to be one that's very unusual. It's called The Toxic Avenger, the feel-goo musical of the year, based on a comic book character, of course. Melvin is transformed into the Toxic Avenger, who battles environmental criminals, all for the love of a blind librarian. Again, this will be from the See 'Em on Stage Productions. We'll hopefully look at that as well.
All right, thank you. And time for our picks now. Poppy!
Sunday, Allison Bynes Rushing, that Slade's wife, formerly of Mila fame, is hosting a pop-up Port City dinner, four courses, $45. Great deal. And then Thomas Mann's exhibit feast is on display at his gallery through November 12th, and he's cooking a special dinner at the gallery on October the 21st to benefit the Kraft Emergency Relief Fund.
Oh, God bless him. And Lars.
Well, we like to invite everyone to come down to the Palm Court restaurant on Wednesday night, especially with Topsy and Louis Ford and the rest of the band.
Sounds good.
Playing.
Thank you. Alan.
Peggy, one of your favorites of mine, Rivertown Theaters is going to be putting on 1776, starting up at the beginning of November. It'll be starring Gary Rucker as John Adams, Matt Reed as Thomas Jefferson, David Hoover as Benjamin Franklin, Terry Utterback as Samuel Chase, and Louis DeDossett as John Hancock, among many, many others.
Okay, thank you. And WYES-TV presents the brand new documentary on Chef Paul Prudhomme, Louisiana legend. That's premiering tomorrow at 10 a.m. right here on WYES. And don't miss Fall for Art, with gallery openings and receptions in downtown Covington. That's tomorrow evening, including the Roland Golden Gallery on North Columbia Street. And A Night for the Dogs will benefit NOLA Lab Rescue with live music, silent auction, open bar, and more at Southport Music Hall. That's tomorrow night. The annual Anba Dalo Halloween Festival and Parade kicks off next Thursday with a water symposium and potluck dinner. Then it continues next Saturday, October 15th at 10 a.m. with a water walk, Halloween costume parade, and live music and performances late into the night, all at the New Orleans Healing Center. Looking ahead, the Louisiana Landmark Society will hold their Fête du Jardin. That's next Sunday at the Pitot House. Tickets are available now, and you can just go to their website. But now we leave you with a scene from the New Orleans Opera Association's Don Giovanni. Now alone with Zerlina, Don Giovanni tells her she shouldn't marry such a bumpkin, but she come instead to his castle, where he will make her his wife. The singers are Daniel Okalich and Irene Carrier Cadu. And the final performance is this Sunday at 2:30 p.m. at the Mahalia Jackson Theater. And thanks to photographer Craig Kramer for the footage. And thank you all very much for watching. Good night.
Those were some names.
Global Star Satellite Communications, headquartered in Covington, Louisiana, connects the world. Global Star Satellite voice and data products offer remote communications for lone workers and backup communications during emergencies and disasters. Global Star's products include Wi-Fi hotspots, tracking devices, and fixed and mobile phones. Be bold, be efficient, be heard. Global Star connects the world.